The next story that I want to take up is about Vishwanath Temple at Kashi. All of you have heard of the Vishwanath Temple. It was destroyed first in the time of Mohammad Ghori, and after that it was destroyed several times. So when it was first destroyed in the time of Mohammad Ghori, then soon after that, some decades after that, Queen Razia came to the throne of Delhi. Now, we all know that Queen Razia had a very turbulent reign. She ruled for only about 4 years, and she was faced with constant challenges from her nobility. Now, it is surprising that a ruler faced with such challenges to her existence, to her life, had the time, or rather found the time, to construct a mosque at the site of the first Vishwanath Temple. So, in those 4 years, Queen Razia Mosque was constructed at the site of the first Vishwanath Temple, which was destroyed by one of the lieutenants of Mohammad Ghori. Now, the temple was rebuilt several times after that at nearby locations, because the original location had been lost. So it was rebuilt again and again, but each time it was destroyed. Finally, in the 16th century, we have an account of Narayan Bhatt. Narayan Bhatt was a very important religious leader who lived in Banaras, and he composed a work that is called the Tristhali Setu. And in this Tristhali Setu, he has one portion which is addressed to the devotees of Vishwanath. And that portion tells the devotee that do not be disheartened if you come to this place and find Vishwanath not there. It is your dharma, it is your duty to ensure that you keep the dharma of this sacred place alive. And how do you do it? You come here and go on worshipping the ling even in the absence of the ling. So this is a statement by a very influential, powerful religious leader, Narayan Bhatt, in his composition, where he is saying that the ling is not there. Subsequently, Narayan Bhatt is involved in the reconstruction of the Vishwanath Temple with the help of Todarmal's son. Todarmal, we all know, was an important revenue official of the time of Akbar. His son was posted in this region. So he and Narayan Bhatt are involved in the reconstruction of the Vishwanath Temple. Now, barely one century this temple survives, because Aurangzeb gives the order to destroy it. And according to very popular stories, the Dashnami order that was there in that area, it fought pitched battles with the troops of Aurangzeb. And the Dashnami sannyasis organized themselves into ascetic militant order to defend Vishwanath. So, it was destroyed, as we all know. But even then, the memory of Vishwanath and the desire to reconstruct that temple, which had been destroyed again and again and again, and that site occupied for the first time by Queen Razia, that remains strong. So in 1777, the Maratha queen Ahilyabai Holkar, she builds the Kashi Mandir. Now it is very interesting that if you go to Kashi temple, which is built by Ahilyabai Holkar, you will not find the Shivling at the center of the temple. Normally, the main murti or the main ling that is worshipped in every temple is always occupying the center of that structure. In the case of Kashi Vishwanath, built by Ahilya Bai, the ling is at one corner. It is not at the center of the temple. Now, this is a violation of the rules of constructing sacred sites. So, how do we explain this? There is a very popular belief that when the Kashi Vishwanath temple was being destroyed on orders of Aurangzeb, the priest picked up the ling and took it to his hut, which was nearby. And he kept it in the hut and went on worshipping it quietly. According to some accounts, the Mughal troops which were stationed nearby knew about it and ignored it, or they were paid bribes and they ignored it. So the ling was kept in the house of this Brahmin priest. And when Ahilya Bai built the temple, she did not disturb the location of that ling. And that is why that ling of Vishwanath is not at the center of the shrine, but is at a distance from the center, because that was the place where the Brahmin priest who rescued that ling from Aurangzeb's troops located it. So this is another fascinating story, that we are able to locate or trace the history of a shrine, the famous Vishwanath shrine, which is first destroyed by Mohammad Ghori's troops, the site occupied by Queen Razia. The temple is built again and again. In the 16th century, it is built by Narayan Bhatt, aided by Todarmal's son, finally destroyed by Aurangzeb, and rebuilt by Queen Ahilya Bai. So, you know, if people argue that the Hindus had no attachment to their sacred sites and sacred structures, and it did not really matter to them if they were destroyed, that is telling half the truth, or actually an untruth. Because all the evidence that is available from every case that I have been able to trace shows continuous commitment and devotion to a deity at a particular site, and the constant attempts made to re-erect a sanctuary or a shrine in honor of that deity.